Oh my god, that looks so good, Brenda. That looks so good. I can't. That looks good.
Oh my god, guys. What? One of my TikTok followers just posted a fire video saying TikTok's getting banned.
What? No, that can't be happening. Tell me you're lying right now.
POV TikTok gets banned?
That's never gonna happen, Queen. Like.
We're cooked!
TikTok get banned?
Well, it's a little more complicated than that. So basically, the
Hey, Poly Parrots!
Welcome back to another episode. My name is Amy.
My name is Valeria, and we'll be your host on today's episode of The Poly 10. Hey, get off your phone. We're in the middle of an introduction.
Yeah, one sec.
Whoa, where'd you get this phone charm from?
Oh, this? I got it from Miller's Outpost.
No way, I got a shirt there too. I didn't know they had phone charms though.
Yeah, they have a whole bunch of cool things.
Oh, really? Let's go check it out then.
My name is Zenda Miller, and I am a special education teacher for students with intellectual disabilities. So Miller's Outpost is a student-based enterprise, which means it's a business run by students or has input from students. The reason why I wanted to start it was to give my students jobs and real life work experience. The biggest challenge would be getting the materials for the store. A lot of it I got through Donors Choose, and then once the program got approved by the district, they did give me a stipend. We do have a limited amount of stickers, and so if you know of something that you like, we have a suggestion box that you can always throw in a suggestion. Seeing the growth in my kids interact with people that they normally don't, they're getting to be like more familiar with them and that they're more social.
Now that we're all fitted, we can finally relax.
Nuh-uh. I have to study for my AP exams.
Oh yeah, AP exams are coming up. People must be stressing.
Let's go see what Poly Parrots have to say about it.
AP season is a very stressful time for every single AP student. It's cramming certain subjects, learning what you don't know, learning the subjects that you do know better. But one thing that it all shares is that it's a very stressful time for all of us.
I would say the most difficult thing when studying for an AP exam is actually figuring out what topics you need to study. And since the AP class is over the course of a whole year, at the end it can be kind of tedious and time consuming to figure out what you actually really need to review and what you don't have to worry about so much.
For example, I'm not going to study especially hard on the subjects that I've already mastered, in my opinion. I'm going to specifically study on the subjects that I still need more time on and still need to gain a little bit of expertise on.
Something I would say is not to be scared of taking APs. It can be very overwhelming. People have a preconceived idea that APs are really hard or they're very time consuming. You should try it first, and if you really don't like it, switch out after.
I would like to say to not overstress yourself over this. I know this is a stressing time, but it's not the end of the world whether you pass or fail an exam. You gain the experience of a college level class, which is something that you will gain from regardless of how you do on the exam. And the stressful times will end soon.
Mr. Rich, what would you like to say to the AP students?
As a former AP teacher, I know how hard they've all worked, and I know how nervous and stressful it can be. So I hope you all the best. Trust what your teachers taught you, answer the questions, and good luck.
Hey, Poly Parrots. It's so exciting you took on these AP exams this year. I wish you every luck, do your best, and just persevere, because it can be super tiring.
Good luck, everybody. I hope you do really well.
Emerson says, trust thyself, because if you're confident, you're going to do well. Good luck.
Good luck on the AP test, you guys. Make me proud.
Les deseo lo mejor. Vayan, perguitos, vuelen y arrebaten y traigan ese cinco a su escuela.
Wishing all my computer science students the best of luck on your exam. May your coding be swift, your algorithms be optimized, and your understanding crystal clear.
Hey y'all, good luck on AP week. You're gonna kill it, you know your stuff. Stay calm, breathe, stay collected, and you'll do amazing.
You've worked hard all year to showcase what you know. Do your best and you will succeed. We believe in you, good luck.
We have been preparing for this for months. You guys have endured my endless lectures, you have endured my activities in labs, and you have endured my occasional temper tantrums. But now the time is here. Exams are right around the corner. Good luck, everyone. Do your best. I have faith in you.
This is a special shout out to all the AP students, but special love to my AP Bio kids. The time has come, you guys. So be sure to eat your glucose, inhale your oxygen. You're gonna need to make all the ATP you can to power your neurons. You got this.
Okay, good luck everyone taking AP exams. I'm sure you're gonna do great.
Don't forget to get a good breakfast and don't study the night before too much because it's gonna stress you out. Good luck.
Good luck, AP students. Let's go AP Human Geography.
Good luck on the test, write lots of essays, and enjoy yourself.
I'd like to wish my AP government students the best of luck on the test. If they study their court cases and the required documents and read them, you'll do great. Best of luck.
The best advice I can give is to study, and study enough so that you walk into that test and you're able to tell yourself, I did everything I could.
You guys can do it. Just try your best, and your best is enough. You can do it. You guys can do it.
I know you've worked hard all semester and or all year for some of you, and just relax and take a breath and trust what you know, and you'll do great. So good luck.
Know that you got this, and know that you are better off now than not having taken that AP class. So again, good luck, everybody. You got this.
I'm so proud of you and all the hard work that you have put in this entire year. I am so confident that you guys are going to be doing your best. We'll be with you in spirit. Do the best you can.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's right. You're going to get a 5 on that AP calculus test. You don't get a 5 on that AP Spanish. Hola. You're going to get a 5 on the chemistry test. You don't get a 5 on the AP push test. Push through. Push through college. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm proud of you. You're going to get that 5. You're going to pass that AP calculus test. You're going to pass that AP bio test. And guess what? Mommy don't say, hello, my daughter and my son made it. Bye. Good luck.
You know, hearing that makes me feel a lot more better about exams. Oh, sorry, I was just going over lines.
Lines?
Right, you're in the Heights. I'm not in the Heights, but we are part of Drum Club's next production for In the Heights.
No, I still haven't gone over my lines yet.
What? If you don't have your lines, your songs, or your dance memorized by now, you're cooked.
Don't remind me, it's making me more nervous.
Jeez, okay, but let's go see what Drum Club is up to.
Katie Groskin. I have taught theater here at Poly for 13 years. Since I started here at Poly, I've done drama club after school as well as during the school day. I'm very excited for the building, you know, to be built and for there to be like a place where people can come to see theater that doesn't have the same kind of outdoor challenges that we've had over the past, you know, years. I just love when everybody is on stage and singing and gets really excited and pumped up and they're just having fun and really expressing themselves and enjoying what they do. Those are 100% my favorite moments.
Mommy made me mash my M&Ms.
Mommy made me mash my M&Ms.
My name is Yael Zarate. I'm a senior this year, and I'm going to be playing the part of Benny in our musical this time. This is actually the first year we're building real-life sets, working with Mr. Bolita and other people here at the school to build like 6 feet, 7 feet tall sets. I've been really lucky enough to actually work on the design for these sets, so I'm really excited to see them all finish soon.
My name is Mr. Bolita. I teach intro to art, drawing, painting, murals. I've been making sets for drama for exactly 1 year. This will be our first real year working together. Usually it is the theater students that help out.
Hello, my name is Emily Rodriguez, and I'm a senior, and I play Vanessa in the musical In the Heights. So one thing that I love about Vanessa is that she's a Latina woman, and She's very confident and she's very goal-oriented. And in the musical throughout, she's trying to find a way to leave her town. She wants to become better for herself. What I admire about Drama Club is the amount of time and the different people in it. I feel we all come together with these ideas and then we're able to create something so wonderful, like these sets or blocking scenes. Actually seeing it, like, it's like a wonderful experience, and I admire that so much in the end.
In the Heights is going to be May 17th and 18th at 7 p.m. at the Freshman Center Amphitheater. And we hope you join us.
Can't wait to see what Drama Club brings us on May 17th.
You know, it'd be fun to see the production with a special someone.
Speaking of a special someone, are you going to prom?
Yeah, but I don't have a date.
That sucks. Let's go see what our poly couples are up to.
Hi, my name is Yanelli, and for this next segment, since we've entered prom season, let's see how well our senior couples know each other.
This is our first couple. Yanelli.
Brian.
Maya Ortega.
Luis Tada.
Oh, yo, Yael.
Matthew.
Oh, yay.
Where was your first kiss? Please show your boards.
Yeah.
Three. 10th grade center, upstairs.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Next question. Where was your first date?
Oh.
All right, you guys ready?
Yeah.
Turn it around.
Okay.
Okay. Ooh, so close.
Oh.
Oh. Now, for our last question.
You get to write a question that you want your partner to answer.
Close your eyes. Okay, give me your board first. Wait, I'm gonna show it to the camera first. Don't. Okay, here you go. Okay, so we're gonna do it one at a time. All right, Maya, can you please open your eyes?
Would you like to co-direct prom with me? Ignore the blue bag.
Yeah.
It's so nice seeing these lovely couples. I hope they
think fast.
Someone's in a sporty mood.
Yeah, I just feel so pumped after that win by girls basketball.
Right? I heard they won city championships.
Not once, but back to back.
Back to back?
Back to back.
Let's go see how they feel after that win.
Girls varsity basketball began their 2023 to 2024 season with a fresh D1 championship win. Starting off their season with new coaches and plays, they once again rose to the occasion and became back-to-back D1 champions, creating poly basketball history.
My name's Samantha Saldana, and I'm one of the captains for the poly girls basketball team. I think my biggest moment this year was probably winning semifinals and realizing that we had a chance of being able to win the championship once again. I feel we did a lot of ISO last year. We just played like street ball, but this year was had a lot more structure. We played a lot better. Last year it was turnover over turnover, a lot of fouls, everyone was in foul trouble, but this year we really played as a team and we executed our plays. Definitely it was nerve-wracking, but I really felt confident in my team and I honestly was really hyped. Compared to last year, I was shaking in my boots.
I think going into the championship, my team, they were prepared because they had won the previous year, and so they were ready and they understood that the weight fell on their shoulders and they knew how to take in the crowd and they knew how to take in the hype and everything.
My overall championship experience with the girls, it was fun. I've been there before, but this year as a head coach, so it was a little bit different. There's a little pressure, you know, of course, you're going for a championship. Your nerves are a little bit off kilter, but you know, once the game starts and when I'm into it and I'm yelling, and then it's just like another game. You're just hoping when you're winning, you're just looking at the clock and wishing that clock would move down a lot faster than it did. For the underclassmen to step up, we kind of had to just make them step up. It was like that whole saying, you're gonna sink or swim. So we threw them out there. If they sunk, they sat on the bench. If they kept swimming, they were staying on that court. I absolutely have faith in them going for a three-peat. They have the tools, they have the players. I'm sure there's gonna be girls moving up, the coaching's there. It's just about them believing in themselves all the way and believing in each other.
Let's see if we could get that three in a row next season.
Wait, that means it'll be back to back to back to back to
okay, back. That's enough. Well, that concludes this month's episode.
Make sure to like and subscribe, and thank you for watching The Poly 10. Across the bridge.